Zabib says when she notified Woodward's relatives in the U.S., they went mute and instead blocked her bank accounts, leaving her without money.
All the money he had, around 12 million at Insambia Hospital. When all that got done, I was unable to get any money. That's all we used. And when he passed on, all his accounts were blocked and I was unable to access any of his accounts.
Zabib further says her husband's body is being kept in one of the funeral homes and the bill has accumulated to over 30 million shillings.
I'm now left with the funeral service who want their money. They've been asking for their money for a long time. The bills are accumulating and I have nothing to do. I don't even have a job. I have nothing to do. His family is unable to respond to me. We can't even talk. They sometimes block even my numbers. Even when I use a different number, they block it.
She further highlights that she has reached out to the American embassy, but she was not helped.
I was left with a big bill for rent. We were paying 1.5 every month. And the landlord just let me live without even paying a single penny. He knew I couldn't afford. He knew I couldn't get money anywhere after my husband had passed on.
According to Zabib, she met Woodward in Oman where she was working and the two later decided to come to Uganda. While in Uganda, Zabib introduced Woodward to her parents and they lived together until he fell sick 2 months ago. Zabib says she wants to bury her husband in Uganda but is frustrated by the bureaucracy.
We met in Oman and on my return to Uganda, we stayed in connection. When I returned to Uganda, he came thrice and on the fourth time, he met my parents. I told him I was a Muslim and he accepted to change. So he's my husband and I would really wish him to have a decent burial here.
Zabib is seeking help from the government and well-wishers to give her husband a decent burial. Report compiled by Judith Nalugwa for the news.